couple ways she can do that shit. She might come in that hole and turn the game off. Like, so who is Keisha? Like, what you talking about? So, what I'm hearing down, I was at the salon today, and they telling me that you talking to a hoe all the way from Foley named Keisha and shit. Like, dog, like, first off, you know not to approach nobody by some shit you heard. But second off, you didn't hear that shit. You just saying this shit because you want me to talk to you. And I don't want to talk to you. And you know I don't want to talk to you. So you're not even going to come with the, hey, I want to talk and shit like that. Because if you came with that shit, I might even, you know what I'm saying, talk to you. But the reason why I don't fuck with you is because you do this sly way bullshit. The shit like Soulja Boy doing. I'll fight anybody. I want my, this my shit. Y'all fucking up the rap game. How in the fuck is somebody fuck? How does anybody fuck up the rap game more than you, my nigga? Like, you came in saying fuck, nigga, you made a dance. The fuck are you talking about? All right, welcome back to the Rap Trap. I am AYO CONSACO, fearless leader of AYO Nation. And this is, in hindsight of the Rap Trap that you've been trapped inside of. Usually we don't see what the fuck we should have done in the first place until after we've made the wrong decision. What you about to see is footage of this nigga, Baby Jesus, the baby, hitting a nigga at a show. Not sure why or whatever like that. Some coked up looking ass nigga, man, you know, whatever the fuck. Check that shit out right fast. Okay, so first off, what I don't like about this shit, the baby. Alright, so what this nigga do is, you done killed the nigga in Walmart. It's footage at another show that you didn't hit a nigga. Now at this show you didn't hit a nigga. Alright, now if Gucci did that, then it's like, alright, that's what that is. But my nigga, and I saw a nigga write on the other video I did about this nigga. Nigga said, I ain't never seen this much hate in my life, whatever like that. And it might be hate, whatever like that. I might be jealous of this nigga position or whatever. I'm fat and he not. Whatever, I'm not sure. But when I get a vibe out of a nigga, and you know, I'm gonna be honest with you. Nigga sent me this shit a couple days ago. When I seen this nigga hit this nigga, I'm like, oh shit. Damn, well, that nigga really did that shit. That nigga walked off the stage, went in the crowd and just whammed the nigga. Shit, this nigga right, I might have been wrong about this. He really might be about that on some real shit. But after further review,
as soon as you start shooting, bitches want to start calling this shit. That shit is retarded. Look, January 22nd, 6 p.m., I'll be going live for the first time on Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, get over there. I said I was going to do it this year, so we doing this shit. I'm speaking to AYO Nation. Y'all know what the fuck going on. The AYO Nation donation conversation. We have that every other Sunday. I shout y'all out when y'all donate and shit like that. But we doing more at this fucking point in time because y'all know YouTube don't pay shit. You know what I'm saying? NBA 2K and stole my goddamn shirts and shit like that. You can see that shit on YouTube. With the shirts, y'all know the shirts. Any shirt you want, any headwear you want, the shirts are going for 15, all shirts all, and all the headwear is going for 10 for the month of January and shit like that. But we speaking on the 22nd. Any question y'all got, scream at me. Also, listen, Listen to this goddamn music that y'all hear in the background. It's not just music I find online. It's real artists with real fucking projects that are, you know what I'm saying, trying to promote themselves. Listen to that shit. Get down in the comment section. Let it be known how the fuck you feel. Most of the time, they'll be in the comment section so you can tell them personally what the fuck they need to do or how you like their music and shit like that. If you're an artist that's trying to get some real exposure with real people, not that Instagram sponsor bullshit, hit me up, but don't hit me up until you're ready to make a transaction. Prices start at $200, up to $2,000, depending on what you want to do, whatever like that. But do not hit me up until you're ready to go to work. I don't have no time to play. I'm trying to sue these fucking folks. Get back to the video. I'll see y'all in a minute. Love.
When I see this nigga hit this nigga and jump back 2 feet, and if you look at his foot, this nigga, you know what I'm saying? He damn near tripped over a nigga trying to back up some more. What that shows me is, and you got to feel me on this, when you actually have to have been through something to understand this, but back in the day, we used to, you know what I'm saying, beef with niggas from another city, another whatever the fuck like that. Y'all meet up at the skating ring and y'all fight and shit like that for no reason, just, you know what I'm saying, old rivalry in the city, whatever the fuck like that. Shit been going on since your uncles and them was going to school and shit, whatever. But you would have a little nigga might be on a football team or some shit like that. This nigga really ain't really bumping like that at all, whatever. But he know that he got the whole, you know what I'm saying, squad behind him. So this be the nigga jumping up and down, you know what I'm saying? Ah, nigga, yeah, you already know. Throwing up his bullshit signs and shit like that. Ah, nigga, you know what the fuck it is? Just whooping. Because he know all he got to do is just spark it off and get the fuck out the way. And melee is going to ensue. You know what I'm saying? He might not, he can run around the whole time. You know what I'm saying? He might not never get touched. But all he got to do is start that shit off. That nigga, I've never respected that fucking position. The nigga who starts the shit. But don't, if you put this nigga in a, all by himself, it's not happening. It's not happening. And this is what I've seen here. I just seen a nigga, knowing that he had niggas behind him, I don't think you just dived in. I think that you seen this nigga was in there by himself, lanky, long, looked broke. You know what I'm saying? Just, you sized him up. Ain't no telling how long, how, you know what I'm saying, this nigga was doing this bullshit, whatever like that. You sized. And after you sized him up, you decided, all right, yeah, you know what I'm saying, I can get away with this shit. So now you walk down real cool, you know what I'm saying, with the squad and shit like that, everybody. Making sure everybody behind you, you know what I'm saying, y'all deep, he by himself. Wow! When I seen how you hit the nigga, it's like you was already backing up. I'm just gonna touch him and go. But the nigga fell, so it looked like a real powerful, but that nigga, he snored a nigga drunk as fuck, you know what I'm saying, throw it off. That shit can happen to anybody, but like I said, it just, the moral of the story is, this shit that you doing, dog. But it's like, you know what I'm saying? This shit gonna come forever because this is the energy. Ever since this shit happened at Walmart with you, dog, I'm listening to your music. I'm listening to the songs that you dropping and shit like that. I really need to do a What You Say episode because that's all you talk about now is kill the nigga, put a nigga up. You know what I'm saying? There's one song he said, ever since I put this nigga up. Like, and it's like, so it's just like you saying that you a gangster. Like, you letting it be known. You know what I'm saying? Like, nigga scared of me now since I murked a nigga. And it's like, dog, it's like, man, shut the fuck up, man. Shut the fuck up, dog. That's like saying nigga scared of Soulja Boy, because he, no, come on, dog, stop that shit. That's not how y'all painted. And y'all not rock like that, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas scared of Gucci Mane just without nothing, just, you know what I'm saying? Just anything. Anything, you know what I mean? You not built like that, and nobody's never gonna look at you like that. And trying to get that image, you gonna end up like Tekashi also. Jock, Baby, the Baby, Baby Jesus, Soulja Boy. This is all, you understand that clout chasing and homosexuality are all wrapped up in one big, you know what I'm saying? One big package, one big spinach roll. You know what I'm saying? It's all in there together. You know what I'm saying? Because hoes can do that. The only man that's going to be online trying to get points is niggas like Bobby Light, you know what I'm saying, fighting on camera and shit like that. That's not, and it's, I don't give a fuck who did it. Quando, Rondo, NBA Youngboy, all that shit is whole shit. I just want some attention. Just look at me. I want some attention. My nigga, look. And I understand the industry is what it is, but it's set up like this. This is the rap trap. They want you to go big, big, big. Go over the top. Show your gun, show your money, show the dope all on camera so that everybody know that you bought it. And then you get bam, or then you get killed. The trap is you put yourself in a position, because that's the only way that you can win. The only way that you can win in this game is either showing money, showing dope, showing guns, or showing that you just don't give a fuck about nothing. But anything that you do to impress other people that's not true in your heart, or that you know isn't in your best interest, at that very moment, you should know it's a fucking trap. I know better than this. I never lived like this. Before I was doing music, I was never doing this. What the fuck happened? If you listen to artists, if you listen to them when they're speaking candidly, you will notice that they let it be known that they didn't have these issues before coming into this game. But you don't hear these same qualms and issues from people in different genres. You know what I'm saying? Because a rock star, country singer, pop star might have to deal with a crazed fan, you know what I'm saying, wanting an autograph, or, you know what I'm saying, like Eminem did and shit like that. But us, we have to deal with crazed fans trying to kill us. And these motherfuckers will put everything else on our mind so that we don't see that this is what the fuck is going on. We are the only motherfucking genre that have to deal with this shit. Even after becoming successful, we still, and sometimes even more, have to dodge bullets in jail cells. A lot of times, niggas don't go to jail until they get on. They never went to jail this much. They never made these kind of mistakes. But these mistakes that they're making are purposely made mistakes. I didn't get caught doing some shit. I put this shit on camera. I did this shit in front of everybody. I wanted people to see this. I needed for this to happen. All this planned fights and shit like this, planned beef, and like I said, with Soulja Boy doing this, I want to fight on camera. I want to fight anybody. What he's saying, it's a movie called They Live. Never saw the movie, but if you're a conspiracy theorist, you hear this shit a lot. In the movie, you got your regular eyes, and then if you put these glasses on, you can see all of the aliens that are in this world. And what I'm saying is, once you've come into this type of, you know what I'm saying, mindset to where you can recognize the bullshit, it's kind of like having those glasses on. You got the glasses on, you can see when motherfuckers are just asking for attention. And that shit comes from, you know, having kids and dealing with hoes and shit like that. You know, like your bitch will be like, just some retarded ass shit a hoe might say. A hoe might, you know what I'm saying? So who the fuck is Keisha and shit like that? Or she might wait till you get home to ask you about Keisha and shit like that, because you playing the game. You know what I'm saying? You playing the game and shit like that. She in the room, you know what I'm saying? You just got out of work, but you don't really want to fuck with her. But, you know what I'm saying? You know if you leave, it's going to start some shit. So you don't want to leave and shit like that. You in a fucked up position. Because if you was a real man, you know what I'm saying? You wouldn't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? You be doing the fuck you want to do. And this hoe would know that. But you in a fucked up position, man. So you just, you know what I'm saying? To play my game, man. Fuck, man. I can't even go outside and shit like that. Because you in a fucked up position. You got to do what the fuck she say. Whatever. So this hoe might goddamn... There's a couple ways she can do that shit. She might come in that hole and turn the game off. Like, so who is Keisha? Like, what you talking about? So, what I'm hearing down, I was at the salon today, and they telling me that you talking to a hoe all the way from Foley named Keisha and shit. Like, dog, like, first off, you know not to approach nobody by some shit you heard. But second off, you didn't hear that shit. You just saying this shit because you want me to talk to you. And I don't want to talk to you. And you know I don't want to talk to you. So you're not even going to come with the, hey, I want to talk and shit like that. Because you just, if you came with that shit, I might even, you know what I'm saying, talk to you. But the reason why I don't fuck with you is because you do this sly way bullshit. The shit like Soulja Boy doing. I fight anybody. I want my, this my shit. Y'all fucking up the rap game. How in the fuck is somebody fuck? How does anybody fuck up the rap game more than you, my nigga? Like, you came in saying fuck. Nigga, you made a dance. The fuck are you talking about? So it's kind of like having those glasses on. Like, when you know what I'm saying? When you come to this certain level, pretty much everybody in AYO Nation, if you are in AYO Nation and you obviously have the glasses on, you can see when niggas just want fucking attention, but can't get, you can't get attention from what you do, so you have to do something else. And I mean it. What? You fucking right. What? And it, like, motherfuckers don't require respect. They just want to, just look at me. Look, that's whole shit. That is something that your bitch would do. Real talk. Look at me. And it's like, I understand this game, but this is what the rap trap consists of. When you have to get attention this way instead of this way. Getting attention on some whole shit. I'm going to get attention because I'm going to punch a nigga. If I punch a nigga, if I shoot a nigga, oh man, the blog going to go crazy. Everybody going to cover this shit. I'm going to be on. Because that's what we seen. That's what we seen. Man, I'm going to show these niggas this dope on camera, man. I know, man, the blog going to go crazy. Because that's what, you know what I'm saying? Once you take the talent out of the game, everything goes haywire. You're not going to find this shit in Ed Sheeran and Katy Perry, Twin Dragons, Marshmello. These motherfuckers got 1 billion views, man. We can't get, dog, if a rapper got 100 million views, that nigga's on top of the world. These motherfuckers getting, because DJ said that shit too, man. DJ said, if you look at the motherfucking difference between the black businesses, like what they make and what the white businesses make, man, that shit ain't even fucking comparable. You know what I'm saying? You look at the black businesses that make over, that make $1 billion a year. So you might got 3 of them motherfuckers. Man, you look at all the goddamn white companies that got make over goddamn $1 billion a year. It's thousands of them motherfuckers. We always at the bottom of the barrel. Always at the bottom. And just down this hole, just fucking shit up. Because we allowed them to come in and snatch our carpet of talent. Y'all niggas doing this shit because you don't believe in your talent. But it's fucked up because there's a lot of niggas with talent that just get looked over. And the game is fucked up like that. And like I'm trying to think of ways to surpass the shit, but they set this shit up like very fucking good. Very fucking good. They got so many fucking things going on that it's just, you have to outthink this shit, and it takes money to do that shit too. So I'm trying to think about it, whatever like that, but until we find another way, I feel like shit just need to stop. Just need to stop. But you can't tell a motherfucker not to get money. And they always gonna dig their fucking hand in the hood and go get a little got it. A little keyed or whatever the fuck these motherfuckers' name is. I'm gonna do a video on these motherfuckers. Just trash ass niggas. Just trash ass niggas. But the kids will take anything that's put in their face. And the fucking people at these fucking labels know this shit. All we have to do is put this shit in their face enough and it's over with. Fuck talent. Put this shit in their face with this, and this, and it's all good. And this, and this is jewelry, hoes, cars. Make him look bigger than what he is and the kids will believe it. Once the kids run with this shit, oh, that's who's on. That's who's on. That's what they follow. So they got the mind of our children, and we have to find a way to get that shit back. And that's why we have to go to war with niggas like DaBaby and Soulja Boy and all these other motherfuckers that don't mind sacrificing our children so that their children can go to private school. Kodak Black, any motherfucker who, I don't give a fuck what you say in your interviews. If what you say in your music is ya, you not for us. You against us. Because you don't want your kids to live that way. But you don't mind ours living that way. You're not my friend, my nigga. And that's how we have to carry that shit. But we have to get the fucking kids away from these stupid bitches. God damn it, because they not going to work for us, man. They not going to put down no fucking law. We got to do that shit, man. So we got work to do, man. We got work to do. It's the Rap Trap. Make sure you hit the PayPal. See y'all in a minute. Love.